yes, a lot of people woke up hypertensive who weren't hypertensive when they went to bed, by definition. One of the reasons is because the new guideline suggests that lower blood pressures are now hypertension, whereas before they were considered pre-hypertension or even normal in some cases. There's a lot of ramifications that are going to come with this guideline. The guideline writers knew that. They felt strong enough that the risks associated with hypertension for downstream cardiovascular disease, heart attack, stroke, and death are substantial enough, and they're very linear. So as blood pressure increases, so does that risk. That this guideline was warranted to be released and hopefully will be acted upon by all of the care providers who were taking care of these additional 20 to 30 million people. So the take-home message of these new guidelines is that blood pressure is important, and knowing what your blood pressure is especially important. If you don't know, you should ask. You should sit down at a kiosk in your local drugstore or your grocery store and take your blood pressure. The numbers are important, and the numbers mean something, especially as you age. So this guideline really helps put some guidance on when we should be treating blood pressure and what the new goals for treatment are.